So then we calculated the expression for capacitance. The capacitance equation is, so you can use this equation, which is 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r by ln d by r. So this is the capacitance of a single core cable. So per meter length, okay, this is for only 1 meter. So if you want for whole length of the cable, this will be multiplied with total length L. Okay, so you can use this formula, or you can use this formula, right? Here C is equal to epsilon r L by 41.4 log d by d to the base 10 into 10 power minus 9 farads. This is the equation of capacitance of a cable for total length. So here L is also considered here. Okay, so either you remember this equation, or you remember this 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r by ln d by r, d by d. Okay, so then we were also derived the expression for calculating the dielectric stress. This dielectric stress is also called as potential gradient. So now the potential gradient or dielectric stress is represented with small g. So that small g value is q by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r into x. Okay, so this is the general expression. X here is the distance, okay, distance from the center of the core. So now so this g value is v by x into ln d by d. So the potential gradient or dielectric stress of a single core cable, g is equal to v by x into ln d by small d. So here V is the operating voltage and D is the diameter of the sheath from here to here. Okay, this total diameter. So from center it will be D by 2 or radius of the sheath. And small d is the diameter of your conductor. And X is the distance. So up to which you want to calculate the this dielectric stress. Okay. So then we also discussed about that where will be the maximum potential gradient or minimum potential gradient. Okay, the maximum potential gradient or dielectric stress will be there on the surface of the conductor. Okay, on the surface of the conductor, the expression for maximum potential gradient is g max is equal to 2 v by d into ln d by d. Here in place of x you will get d by 2. Okay, so from center to the surface of the conductor, the length x will be small d by 2. So in place of x in the previous equation, you will substitute small d by 2 so that you will get the maximum potential gradient. Okay, and the minimum potential gradient will be observed on the surface of the sheath. Okay, so this is the surface of the sheath. Right, the surface of the sheath will be at a distance of d by 2 from the center of the conductor. So in place of x you have to substitute capital D by 2 so that you will get the minimum potential gradient, which is g minimum is equal to 2 v by d into ln capital D by small d. Okay, the potential gradient is expressed in volts per meter. So these are the units. And we also derive the most economical conductor size. Right, so the most economical conductor size in a cable is small d is equal to capital D by E. Right, so this E is nothing but 2.718. okay, this is the most economical conductor diameter. Okay, so now if this D is substituted in this G max expression, so then G max will become 2 V by small d. Okay, for a most economical conductor diameter, the G max value will be generally 2 V by small d, which is V here is operating voltage, D is the diameter of the conductor. Okay, these are the equations what you have to remember to solve the problems. So let us see today the problems. So we are going to solve the numerical problems on insulation resistance, dielectric stress and capacitance for of a single core cable. Okay, upon completion of this lecture, you can solve the numerical problem which is related to insulation resistance, dielectric stress and capacitance of a single core cable. You can also calculate the most economical conductor diameter of a cable. Okay, right. So let us see the first problem. Okay, so a single core cable has a conductor diameter of 1 centimeter and the insulation thickness of 0.4 centimeter. If the specific resistance of the insulation is 5×10^14 ohm centimeter, then calculate the insulation resistance for a 2 kilometer length of the cable. Okay, so here you have to take the. Is my PPT is visible, ma? Right. Now you are getting. Okay. So example one, you are going to calculate the insulation resistance. So for a single core cable. Okay, now you are seeing the PPT, right? Okay. Right, you have to calculate the insulation resistance for a 2 kilometer length of the cable, and here the conductor diameter is given. So the conductor diameter is 1 centimeter. So that means a small d value is given, which is 1 centimeter, and insulation thickness is given. So if you observe here a single core cable, so here you are having one single core or conductor, and on which you are having the insulation. Okay, so now here this diameter is given. So this total diameter of the conductor is given as 1 centimeter. D is given as 1 centimeter. So and the thickness of insulation is given. That means from conductor surface to up to the sheath. So this is the thickness of your insulation. This thickness of insulation is given as 0.4 centimeter. Okay. So then what will get from center of the conductor to surface of the sheath? So this will be the capital D by 2 value. Okay. So capital D by 2, so which is equal to, so thickness 1 centimeter, sorry, 0.44 centimeter insulation thickness plus small d by 2, you will get, that means 0.4 plus 1/2 is the d by 2 value. Okay, so in terms of radius also you can explain, right? You are having the conductor, right? From the center to surface of the conductor, this is the radius, right? The radius of the conductor, let it be represented with R1. So that R1 will be 1/2. Okay, so see here, so your diameter is 1 centimeter, so radius is 1/2 value, which is 0.5 centimeters. Okay, so then the length of the cable is given as 2 kilometers, so in meters it will be 2000 meters, and resistivity of the insulation is given 5×10^14 ohm centimeters. Okay, so ohm centimeters it is given, so you convert them into meters. So to convert them centimeters to meter, you have to multiply this value with 10^-2, so then you will get 5×10^12 ohm meters. Okay, so now internal sheath radius, so internal sheath radius is nothing but from the center of the conductor to surface here. Okay, so this is the R2 value. So this R2 value is not given in the problem. So but they were given the thickness. Okay, this network thickness of insulation is 0.4 centimeters. Okay, so then the radius of the conductor is 0.5. So the sum of these two, 0.5 plus 0.4. So this will be the sheath diameter. Sorry, sheath radius, internal sheath radius. So that value R2 is equal to 0.5 plus 0.4, which is 0.9 centimeters. Okay, right. Now insulation resistance of the cable can be determined by the expression R is equal to rho by 2 pi L into log R2 by R1 to the base E. Okay, here rho value is given 5 into 10 power 12 ohm meters by 2 pi into length of the cable is 200 meters. And R2, R2 value is 0.9 centimeters and R1 value is 0.5 centimeters. Okay, you substitute the values. So you will get the insulation resistance of the cable as a 0.234 into 10 power 9 ohms. So in mega ohms, it will be 234 mega ohms. Okay. This is how you can calculate the insulation resistance of a given cable. Right. See another problem. Now here, the insulation resistance of a single core cable is 495 mega ohms per kilometer. Okay. If the core diameter is 2.5 centimeter and resistivity of the insulation is 4.5 into 10 power 14 ohm centimeter, find the insulation thickness. Okay, here you have to find out the insulation thickness of the cable, right? Again, see here. So take the conductor on which you have the insulation. Okay, so now in this problem, your aim is to determine the this insulation thickness, this value. Okay, so now here, what are the values given? Insulation resistance value is given. That means the R value is given, so which is 495 mega ohms per kilometer. So this is for only 1 kilometer. Okay. So and core diameter is given. So core diameter is nothing but conductor diameter. So the conductor diameter is 2.5 centimeter. So the radius will be 2.5 by 2, which is 1.25 centimeters is the conductor radius. Okay. Conductor or core, both are the same. Okay. So the R value is 495 mega ohms per kilometer. So now here you consider 1 kilometer of the cable. So let L be the length of the cable, which is 1 kilometer. So 1 kilometer in the sense 1000 meters. Okay. So now for the insulation will be 495 mega ohms. Okay. This is per kilometer. So as the length of the cable also 1 kilometer. The total resistance will be the same. R is equal to 495 mega ohms, or this can be written as 495 into 10 power 6 ohms. Okay, and the resistivity of the insulation is also given, which is 4.5 into 10 power 14. Okay, rho value is 4.5 into 10 power 14 ohm centimeters. So now you convert that centimeters into meters. Okay, so if you want to convert centimeters into meter, you have to multiply this value with 10 power minus 2. So then you will get the resistivity rho as 4.5 into 10 power 12 ohm meters. Okay, so now let R2 be the internal sheath diameter. Okay, R2 is internal sheath diameter, that means from center of the conductor to surface of the sheath. So this will be the R2 value. Okay, and conductor radius is R1 value from here to here. So this will be R1. Okay, now you have to find out this thickness, right? So this thickness value is equal to what? So this R2 from this diagram, we can say that R2 is the sum of R1 plus so thickness of your insulation. Let it be represented with T. Okay. So thickness of insulation, this length plus R1 will be your R2. So from this equation, you can say that thickness of insulation is equal to R2 minus R1. Okay, you know the value of R1, which is the conductor radius, which is 1.25 centimeter, and you have to find out the R2 value. Okay, so now take the expression insulation resistance, which is R is equal to rho by 2 pi L into ln R2 by R1. Okay, so here this value is given and rho value is given, length is given, R2 R1 value is also given. So now you have to find out the R2 value only. Okay, now ln R2 by R1 value will be equal to 2 pi L into R by rho. So now here you substitute the value of capital R, which is 495 into 10 power 6, and rho value is 4.5 into 10 power 12. So then you will get this ln R2 by R1 as 0.69. Okay, so now you convert this ln to log. So either you can convert this ln to log, or you can directly take the value as R2 by R1 is equal to, so here you are having base E. So this will be R2 by R1 is equal to E power 0.69 you will get. Okay, so E power 0.69. So then R2 is equal to, so R1 into, so E power 0.69. Now R1 value, if you substitute 1.25 centimeter, so then you will get the R2 value. That R2 value is 2.5 centimeters. Okay, so 2.5 centimeters is the your R2. Then insulation thickness from this expression can be written as R2 minus R1. So which is 2.5. R2 value is 2.5 and R1 value is 1.25. So insulation thickness is 1.25 centimeters. Okay. Right. Understood. So if you're having any doubt, so you can ask me in the chat box. Now let us see another problem. So now here problem number 3, a single core cable 5 km long has an insulation resistance of 0.4 megaohms. The core diameter is 20 mm and the diameter of the cable over the insulation is 50 mm. Then calculate the resistivity of the insulating material. So now here you have to find out the resistivity rho value. Okay, other parameters are given, so you have to find out the rho value. Okay, right. So here length of the cable L is 5 kilometers. Okay, 5 kilometers. If you convert kilometers into meters, the L value will be 5000 meters. So then the insulation resistance is given. Insulation resistance is 0.4 megaohms. So that means 0.4 into 10 power 6 ohms. And the core diameter is given here. So core diameter is nothing but conductor diameter. So the conductor radius will be diameter by 2, which is 20 by 2. So as 20 is given in mm, the radius also will be in mm. Okay, so then the diameter of the cable over the insulation, so this, that means the this sheath diameter is given, internal sheath diameter, so this will be 50 mm. Then internal sheath radius will be 50 by 2, so which is 25 mm. Okay, so now you have to find out the resistivity of insulation rho value. Okay, so again the insulation resistance of the cable expression is R is equal to rho by 2 pi L into long R2 by R1. Okay, so then you substitute all the values in this expression. R value is 4 into 10 to the 6, and 2 pi into rho you have to calculate by 2 pi into L value is 5000 into long. So R2 by R1, R2 value is 25 mm and R1 value is 10 mm. Okay, so the from this if you calculate the rho value what you will get here is 13.72 into 10 power 9 ohms and ohm meters. Okay, so somebody raised the hand in what is the problem? Is there any doubt here, ma'am? Okay, right. These are the problems which are related to insulation resistance. Okay, so first three problems are the problems which are related to insulation resistance. Now let us see the problems which are to calculate the capacitance. Okay, so next problem. So now here a single core cable has conductor diameter of 1 centimeter. Okay, conductor diameter or core diameter is 1 centimeter. And the internal sheath diameter is 1.8 centimeter. Now, if the impregnated paper of relative permittivity 4 is used as insulation, calculate the capacitance for 1 kilometer length of the cable. Okay, so length of the cable L is 1 kilometer. L here is 1 kilometer, and conductor diameter is represented with small d. So that small d value is 1 centimeter, and internal sheath diameter is represented with capital D. That capital D value is 1.8 centimeter, and relative permittivity is of the insulation is given. Insulation used in the cable is impregnated paper, and this impregnated paper relative permittivity epsilon R value is given as 4. Okay, so now the capacitance of the cable expression is C is equal to epsilon R L by 41.4 into ln capital D by small d into 10⁻⁹ farads. Okay, this is the expression to calculate the capacitance of the cable. Now here in this problem, all the values are given. Epsilon R value is 4, and length L is 1 kilometer, and internal sheath diameter capital D is 1.8 centimeters, and small d is 1 centimeter. Okay, so you substitute all the values. Right, here 1 kilometer is given. You convert them into meters. So then you will get 1000 meters. Okay. So this ratio, when you take d by d, this ratio. So when this capital D is represented in centimeters, so then small d also should be in centimeters. Suppose if it is in meters, it is also in meters. Okay. As small d is in centimeters, here also it should be in centimeters. So here you no need to convert into meters. Why? Because these two are in the same measuring meters. Okay, same, both are measuring in centimeters only. So now you substitute all the values. So then you will get the capacitance of this single core cable is 0.378 into 10⁻⁶ farads. Okay, so now 10⁻⁶ is nothing but micro. So it will be 0.378 microfarads. So then next problem. So now here calculate the capacitance charging current of a single core cable used on the 3-phase 66 kV system. So the cable is 1 kilometer long, having a diameter, core diameter of 10 centimeter, and an impregnated paper insulation of thickness 7 centimeter. So the relative permittivity of the insulation may be taken as 4, and the supply frequency as 50 hertz. Okay, so here in this problem, you have to calculate the capacitance as well as charging current also. Okay, capacitance and charging current of the cable, right? So now the operating voltage is 66 kV, which is a 3-phase system. Okay, this is a 3-phase 66 kV voltage, and cable length is 1 kilometer, and core diameter. So core diameter is 10 centimeter. And impregnated paper insulation is using here. So this insulation thickness is given. So diameter is not given. Thickness is given, which is 7 centimeters. And relative permittivity of insulation epsilon R value is also given, which is the 4. Okay. And frequency is given as 50 hertz. Okay. So now you have to calculate the capacitance and charging current. So if you see the capacitance of a cable expression, this capacitance C is equal to epsilon R L by 41.4. Ln capital D by small d into 10⁻⁹ farads. This is the expression to calculate the capacitance of a single core cable. Now in this expression, the value of epsilon r is given, so which is equal to 4, and the length of the cable is also given, which is the 1 kilometer. So that means 1000 meters. Okay, so now small d is the core diameter. So that core diameter is given as 10 centimeters. Then what about the capital D here? Okay, so capital D value is the insulation. Internal sheath diameter is the capital D. That internal sheath diameter capital D is not directly given in the problem. So instead of that, they were given the insulation thickness. So thickness of insulation is given, which is 7 centimeters. So how we can determine the capital D? So this is your cable, let us assume. Now diameter, core diameter, this value is small d, right? So now internal sheath diameter, in a sense, from here to here, so this total length, this will be the capital D value. Okay, so now here the thickness of the insulation is given. That means from here to here, this value is given. So this is 7 centimeter. So this is 7 centimeter in a sense, from here to here also the thickness will be the same. This is also 7 centimeter. Okay, so then capital D value is equal to, so 7 plus this core diameter 10 plus 7. So that means 7 plus 10 plus 7. This is the value of your internal sheath diameter, which is equal to 24. Okay, capital D value is 24 centimeters. Okay, now you got the D value, capital D value also. So now you got all the values in this expression. You just simply substitute all the values. You can get the capacitance of a single core cable, right? So the capacitance of single core cable C is equal to 0.254 microfarads you are getting. Okay, by substituting all the values, the capacitance of single core cable is 0.254 microfarad. Okay, this capacitance value is per phase value. Okay, this is for only one phase, or you can say that this is the per phase value. Okay, so now you have to also find out the charging current. Charging current is the nothing but current flowing through the capacitance. Okay, charging current, which is represented with IC, that IC value is equal to V phase by reactance of that capacitance. That means XC. So V phase by XC. So now XC, capacitance XC is the V phase by XC value is 1 by omega C. So IC will be omega C into V phase. Okay. So omega here is 2 pi F. So this IC value can be written as 2 pi F into V phase into C. So 2 pi F into C V phase. Okay. So for here, you know the value of capacitance. So which is 0.254 microfarad. You are calculating. Okay. This is the per phase value. Now, what is V phase here? So in the given problem, it is a three phase system with 66 kilovolts. So that means this voltage is the line to line voltage. So now you convert this line voltage into phase voltage. So that phase voltage is equal to 66 by root 3. So this value is 38.1 kilovolts, or you can say that 38.1 into 10 cube volts. Okay. So now if you substitute the values of frequency, capacitance and V phase, you will get the charging current. So the charging current is 2 pi into F here is 50 and capacitance is 0.54 microfarads. Micro here is nothing but 10 power minus 6 into, so this voltage value 38.1 into 10 power 3. So now if you calculate this value, the charging current what we are getting here is 3.04 amperes. Okay. Right. Let us see the another problem. So problem number 6. So here a 33 kV 50 hertz three phase underground cable 4 kilometer long uses the three single core cables. Okay, so here is, it is a 33 kV 50 hertz three phase underground cable 4 kilometer long uses a three single core cables. So each of the conductor has a diameter of 2.5 centimeters and the radial thickness of insulation is 0.5 centimeter. Okay, so determine the capacitance of the cable per phase, charging current per phase and total charging kilovolt ampere reactive. So KVAR you have to find out, and the relative permittivity of insulation is 3. Okay, epsilon value, epsilon R value is 3 value. Now you take the first bit, capacitance of the cable per phase you have to calculate. Okay, the capacitance of the cable per phase is C is equal to, the expression is epsilon R L by 41.4 into ln capital D by small d. So not, is it not ln, this is log capital D by small d to the base 10 into 10 power minus 9 farads. Okay, here what are the values given here? So here epsilon R value is 3 and length of the cable is given as 4 kilometers. So 4 kilometers is nothing but 4000 meters and conductor diameter is 2.5 centimeters. That means small d value is 2.5 centimeters and here thickness is given, right? So thickness of insulation is 0.5 centimeter. So the total diameter d is equal to, so that thickness value 0.5 plus cable diameter 2.5 plus 0.5. So like we were calculated in the previous problem. Okay, so that means 2.5 this one, so 3.5 you will get. So 3.5 is your internal sheath diameter. Okay, capital D value. So now in this expression you got all the values, epsilon r, l, capital D, and small d. So you simply substitute all the values in this expression, you will get the capacitance of the cable per phase. Okay, so the capacitance of the cable per phase value is 1984 into 10 power minus 9 farads. Okay, so then charging current. So charging current, this is also calculated in the previous case. So here to calculate the charging current, IC value is V phase by XC. So that expression will be 2 pi f into C into V phase. So now V phase here is this is the system is 3 phase, 33 kV. So this 33 kV is the line voltage. You convert that into phase voltage. That phase voltage is 33 into 10 kV by √3, so which is 19.05 into 10 kV. This is the phase voltage, and this is the capacitance value. Okay, so now frequency is given as 50 Hz. So you can determine the charging current. So charging current per phase IC is equal to V phase by XC, which is 2 pi f into C into V phase, and F is 50 Hz, and C value is 1984 into 10 power minus 9, and V phase value is 19.05 into 10 cubed. Okay, you substitute all the values in this expression, so you will get the charging current per phase, which is the 11.87 amperes. Okay, right. So then what is the another thing you have to calculate here? Charging kVAr, so volt ampere reactive. So what is volt ampere reactive? So this is nothing but your reactive power. Okay, so reactive power, which is Q. So how you can represent the reactive power? Active power is represented with P. So these units are watts. So then VI cos phi. Okay. So what about this Q? So Q is the reactive power. If it is for 3 phase, so this will be here 3. So here also 3 into V phase into IC. So here you have to calculate the power that is delivered by your capacitance here. Capacitance is your cent parameter. Okay, so in the cent parameter only have the capacitance. Okay, so this capacitance will be having an angle of 90 degrees. So Q is equal to 3 V phase I phase sine 90. Sine 90 value is 1. So you can directly take Q is equal to 3 into V phase into IC. Okay. Now V phase value is 19.05 into 10 cube, and IC value is 11.87 amperes. Now if you substitute those two values here, so you are getting 678.5 into 10 cube kilovolt amperes. Okay. So this is how you can calculate the kilovolt ampere reactive. So instead of asking kilovolt ampere, you can also ask like this: calculate the active power delivered by the your not active power, reactive power delivered by your capacitance. Okay. So reactive power delivered by the capacitance is represented in terms of kilovolt ampere reactive. Right. Okay, so let us see the another problem. So a 33 kV single core cable has a conductor diameter of 1 cm and a internal sheath diameter of 4 cm. So find the maximum and minimum stress in the insulation. Okay, so here you have to find out the dielectric stress. So the dielectric stress expression. So dielectric stress, or you can say that that is the potential gradient. So the potential gradient, maximum and minimum values you have to calculate. Okay, so the maximum and minimum stress of the insulation, so expressions are you already know. So that Gmax value, so maximum potential gradient or maximum dielectric stress or dielectric strength, so that value Gmax is equal to 2V by small d into ln capital D by D. So this is the expression to calculate the maximum stress. And to calculate the minimum stress, this is the expression. So 2V by capital D into ln capital D by small d. Okay, so now in these two expressions you have to know the value of voltage. So V here is the operating voltage. Okay, And d is the internal sheath diameter, which is given as 4 cm. And small d is the core diameter or conductor diameter, which is 1 cm. Okay, small d value is given, capital D value is given, operating voltage V also given. Okay, you just need to remember the formulas, and in the formula you have to substitute all the values. Our V here is 33 kV, and small d is 1 cm, and capital D is 4 cm. So now if you substitute in this formula, you will get the G max value. So that G max value is 47.61 kilovolts per centimeter. Okay, so this potential gradient always will be expressed in either volt per meter or volt per centimeter. Okay, so this is the RMS value. So here if you take the operating voltage V as V in RMS, so this G max dielectric stress also will be the RMS value only. So if you take this is the peak value, so then this value also will be peak value, kilovolts per centimeter peak you have to write. Okay, so in a similar manner you can calculate the minimum stress. So the minimum stress, G minimum is equal to 2V by capital D here, capital D ln capital D by small d. So now again you substitute all the values, V is 233 kV and capital D is 4, and small d value is 1. Okay, you substitute all the values. The G minimum value what you are getting here is 11.9 kilovolts per centimeter, which is RMS value. Okay, so this is how you can calculate the maximum and minimum stress in the cable. So now let us see the another problem. So a single core cable for use on 11 kV 50 Hz system has conductor area of 0.645 cm² and internal sheath diameter of internal diameter of the sheath is 2.18 cm. Permittivity of dielectric used in the cable is 3.5. So then find the maximum electrostatic stress, minimum electrostatic stress, capacitance of the cable per kilometer, and charging current. Okay, here you have to calculate all the parameters. So maximum stress, minimum stress, capacitance, and charging current. Okay, now if you observe here, in the given problem they were given the conductor area, so they were not given the conductor diameter. Okay, so in all the problems conductor diameter is given directly. So but here instead of giving the conductor diameter, so they were given the conductor area. Okay, so conductor area A is equal to, as it is a round conductor, for circular conductor what is the value of area of cross section formula? So area of cross section is pi r square, right? This is the area of cross section of the conductor. So now r can be written in terms of diameter as small d by 2. So this can be written as, so pi d square by 4. Okay, so the area of cross section A is equal to pi d square by 4. So from this you can write d square as 4a by pi. 4a by pi. So now from this d can be written as under square root 4a by pi. Okay, here area of cross section is given, which is the 0.645 cm². Okay, now you substitute this value here in this expression, you will get the diameter in centimeters, so which is 0.906 cm. Okay, and internal sheath diameter capital D value is directly given, which is the 2.18 cm. Okay, 2.18 cm is the capital D value. So then you just remember the formulas to calculate the maximum electrostatic stress and minimum electrostatic stress. Maximum electrostatic stress or maximum potential gradient, G max value is 2V by small d into ln capital D by small d. Okay, so now here operating voltage is 11 kV. Okay, so you substitute the V is 11 kV and small d is 0.906 cm and capital D value is 2.18 cm. So then you will get a G max value as 27.65 kilovolts per centimeter, which is the RMS value. Okay. So now minimum electrostatic stress in the cable is determined with G minimum 2V by capital D into ln D by D. So here V is 11 kV and capital D is 2.18 and small d is 0.908. So if you substitute all the values, G minimum value is 11.5 kilovolts per centimeter RMS value. Right. Along with that, you also you need to calculate the capacitance of the cable. So capacitance of the cable expression is this: C is equal to epsilon R L by 41.4 log capital D by small d to the base 10. Okay, here a base 10 into 10 power minus 9 farads. So now in this problem, epsilon R value is the permittivity of insulation. So that permittivity of insulation of the cable, so that is given as 3.5. Okay, permittivity of dielectric used here is 3.5. Epsilon R value is 3.5, and length of the cable is what is the length of the cable? So length of the cable, if it is not given, so then let us you consider the length of the cable as 1 kilometer. Okay, length of the cable you take 1 kilometer, which is 1000 meters. And capital D and small d values are known here. So now simply substitute all the values. So then capacitance of the cable is 0.22 into 10 power minus 6 farads. Right? If you know the capacitance value, you can calculate the charging current. So charging current IC is equal to 2 pi F CV. Okay. So FE is 50 hertz and C value is 0.2 to 10 power minus 6. And V is the per phase value you have to consider. Okay. So what is given in the problem? Is the line voltage. So here you have to consider phase voltage only. So here 11,000 by root 3 you have to consider. Okay. So here it is given wrong. So here it will be 11,000 by root 3. Okay. So then you will get the charging current value. Okay. This value is wrong. Why? Because here they were substituted the 11 kV directly. Okay. But this expression is for per phase value. So here V phase value. V is the per phase value. So the 11,000 by root 3 you have to get. Okay, you calculate that value. So then you will get the charging current. So let us see the last problem. So determine the economic overall diameter of the single core cable seated for a working voltage of 85 kilovolts if the dielectric strength of the insulating material is 65 kilovolts. Right, here you have to calculate the economical overall diameter of the core. So that means small d is equal to, so 2V by G max. You got this problem. So most economical conductor diameter is small d value is equal to 2V by G max. V here is the operating voltage and G max is the dielectric strength or potential gradient, maximum potential gradient of the insulation. So working voltage is 85 kilovolts and G max value is 65 kilovolts per centimeter. Okay, now you substitute 85, V is 85 volts and G max value is 65 in this equation, then you will get the diameter of the conductor. So the diameter of the conductor what you are getting here is 2.6 centimeter. So then if you get the diameter of the conductor, so what is the diameter of the sheath? So diameter of the sheath. So while deriving the expression for most economical conductor, so you are getting one expression here. See. You see here, while deriving the most economical conductor sign in a cable, so you are getting a capital D by small d value is E. Okay, so from this D can be written as E into small d. Okay, so capital D value is E into small d. Okay, that means if you multiply the diameter D with E, expression E, so E value is 2.718, then you will get the internal sheath diameter.